Welcome back to Poland Daily History, where we're looking at Poland's geographical, geopolitical situation, which of course is very much influenced by its geography and its neighbours. And we've now reached the Second World War. Albert, we were saying earlier about the immediate position before the Second World War. Of course, on the 1st of September, the war started with the Germans, the attack at Westerplatte.
Absolutely. Well, just to go back a little bit, Hitler formulated his demands to create an extraterritorial corridor to Gdańsk officially in March of 1939. This was rejected by the Polish side. And in April, he ordered preparations for the Fallweiss.
And it's probably, and it's in between that point, of course, that there had been this assurance given,
yes,
this guarantee given by the British and the French, yes, to say to Hitler,
yep,
thus far no further. And I just wonder if we might, I think this is in Andrew Roberts, is an eminent English historian, point of view, that the promise to Poland should be seen rather, I mean, historians like to discuss these issues, should be seen rather as a warning to Hitler than necessarily a serious undertaking to Poland. I mean, do you think that's him, as a British historian, sort of arguing ex post facto, or do you think that may have been in the thinking of the politicians at the time?
I mean, realistically speaking, looking at the potential that Germany had, even the one that was known, not all of it was known, versus what France and the United Kingdom had, it was a fairly obvious, and should have been fairly obvious to Poland, that it is unlikely. And looking also at the previous record of Munich, of appeasement, of doing nothing when Hitler was going further and further in his actions, that it's unlikely for the Allied diplomacy to suddenly change course.
And of course, I think it's probably worth it, because we're talking about geopolitical affairs and Poland's geography. Had the roles been reversed, my first question, if I'd been British and my security had been guaranteed by Poland, my first question would have been, where's your navy? And
sure.
So I'd have thought Poland's first question, the British, is yes, but where's your army? And of course, traditionally, we, as the United Kingdom, we'd never had large armies. We'd had large navies because we're an island, and of course, that gave us both security
and prosperity.
And prosperity. And this, we sort of, the world was literally our oyster. And you think it would, but I think that it's fair to say that Beck particularly regarded the Anglo-French sort of guarantee as a sort of a trump card with which he could therefore sort of goad Germany a bit more, or not goad, but be less concerned about Germany.
Absolutely. A tragic miscalculation, many terms, unforgivable one. Because again, in 1939, with the rejection of the Hitler's proposal, and looking at how Poland looked, even with conflict with the Germans, Poland was lost. There was no winning that war.
And of course, although it turned out to be tragically prescient, but for different reasons, it's probably worth pointing out that in 1939 there were Anglo-French attempts with Russians, with the Soviet, to actually have some sort of alliance, anti-German alliance. I think at that point the Soviet Union had foreseen what could happen with Germany. But this fell because it would have required Soviet troops having access through Poland to get to Czechoslovakia.
Yes.
And of course, the government at the time said, well, you know, Germany will cause us to lose our freedom, but Russia will cause us to lose our soul. And so therefore, these, which I think it's fair to say were probably fairly half-hearted on the part of the British and the French. But I mean, Poland did have an opportunity even at that point.
Absolutely. Well, at that point, the moment that our allies proposed that we station Soviet troops or allow their passage through the Polish territory was exactly the time we should have really reconsidered our stance against Germany. Because that was obvious that this is a very transactional kind of affair, and we cannot hope for a consistent and fully devoted support there. And it's interesting because this was, I think, in April presented as a possibility to the Polish government while the British delegation was coming back from Moscow. And I would imagine the moment that proposal was fielded, we should have really started talking to the Germans.
I mean, there were some sort of rather comic elements about it. I mean, the British delegation left to go to Moscow via ship You know, we have Chamberlain, we have people flying around everywhere in airplanes. But for this sort of peace attempt, the British delegation left by ship, which would take them ages to get to Moscow. I mean, rather, all very strange. But of course, it didn't work out. Then we had the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact.
Absolutely. And its secret annex.
And its secret annex, which essentially said, ha, Poland is doomed whatever happens.
Yes.
And so Germany invaded on the 1st of September. And really, Poland, despite the brave fighting, just didn't really have the resources to ultimately resist.
Well, Poland, yes, there was no way to effectively counter Germans, also no way to effectively counter the brilliant, arguably, doctrine of Blitzkrieg, which amounted to revolution in military affairs. Very much, it was a game changer. We did deliver a counterattack, which delayed the ultimate German victory, with the Army Poznań, for example, pushing from the west and forcing the Germans to shorten the lines, a retreat. Otherwise, Warsaw, which was taken on 28th of September, would have probably been taken much earlier by the Germans. But then again, the Soviets came through on the secret annex of the Ribbentrop-Molotov and attacked Poland on 17th of September. And even then, there is a controversy because the Polish government ordered its troops not to engage in fighting with the Soviets, which to this day allows Russia to portray this as an intervention or entry into Poland rather than an invasion and an act of war.
So, yeah, and that's very interesting. I mean, that's probably something we can explore later, but thank you very much for telling us about the outbreak of the Second World War in Poland.